How could a plane that served no time in combat be one of the most iconic aircrafts of all times? Fuck around and find out, that's how. If this plane were named today, it might have been called the B-36 FAFO. But its 1949 official, and perhaps more tasteful name, was the B-36 Peacemaker. Theodore Roosevelt is credited with popularizing the saying, "Speak softly and carry a big stick, you will go far." And in the era of the Cold War, the B-36 was the US of A's big stick. Designed during World War II, the B-36 Peacemaker was a strategic bomber built by the Convair Division of General Dynamics. First taking flight in 1946, the B-36 was an engineering marvel. Its sheer size was amazing, with a wingspan reaching 230 feet. The aircraft boasted 6 Pratt & Whitney radial engines, later upgraded to include 4 jet engines as well. This combination allowed the Peacemaker to fly at speeds up to 435 miles per hour and reach altitudes of 40,000 feet. One of the most remarkable features of the B-36 was its extraordinary range, its maximum reaching over 10,000 miles. The B-36 could conduct intercontinental missions without refueling, making an essential asset during a time when aerial refueling capabilities were limited. The aircraft's impressive payload capacity allowed it to carry up to 72,000 pounds of ordnance, including conventional bombs, nuclear weapons, and guided missiles. Prominently featured in the movie Strategic Air Command, you could make the argument that the B-36 was the actual star of the first half of the movie. There were large scenes devoted to watching it soar through the skies, accompanied by complex musical scores. This movie was 1955's version of Jurassic Park, or even The Matrix, movies that pushed the boundaries of visual effects for that time. But the Peacemaker was no work of fiction. It was real, it was ours, and it was piloted on screen by leading man Jimmy Stewart, who was at that time an actual colonel in the United States Air Force, who would later reach the rank of Brigadier General, becoming the highest-ranking Hollywood actor to serve in uniform. By the late 1950s, technology had advanced. Newer and more efficient bombers, like the B-52 Stratofortress, began to emerge. The Peacemaker had become obsolete and was gradually retired from service. Only 4 B-36 Peacemakers survive today. They are located in the National Museum of the U.S. Air Force in Ohio, the Pima Air and Space Museum in Arizona, Strategic Air Command and Aerospace Museum in Nebraska, and Castle Air Museum in California. The B-36 Peacemaker is truly a giant in the history of aviation and a symbol of peace through deterrence. Do you think the B-36 is awesome? Hit that like button. And if you'd like to see more videos like these, please consider subscribing.